Parkinson's?
2 years ago, I think. Okay. But I've had it a long time, I think. Uh-huh. It got worse after a slip disc.
After a slip disc?
Yeah. Talk some?
Yeah.
Okay. When was the slip disc?
2 years ago.
2 years ago. Where?
L4, L5.
When you say L4, yeah, I hear L3. Yeah. I think why L3, L5, not L4.
Can I leave this here?
You can totally do that. Okay.
I was always shaky.
You were always shaky?
Yeah. And then it got very bad in my right hand when I had pain in my back. And I think it's got worse since.
Yeah. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Thank you. How old are you?
65.
Yeah. Okay. And then what's your medical history in general?
Okay.
What have you had in your life prior?
High blood pressure.
Okay. What else?
High blood pressure. And he's got an accident here with his fingers.
Yeah, what's this? What happened there?
He can tell you best.
That was about...
Wait, you're a practitioner, don't you know that the wife always told her the real story?
She didn't know me when this happened, that these were put off and sewn on again, the ends of the fingers.
What age?
27, 28.
Okay.
You got pulled into a fan, and about three fingers, they were split in the length. But it doesn't hurt now.
Well, yeah, no, I know now it doesn't hurt, but it does, but it hurt then.
Yeah, it hurt.
I mean, okay. Anything else in your high blood pressure? The L5 thing, I think, okay, and the high blood pressure. The thing is, if he says this started going berserk,
yeah,
like before you had some in the right hand.
Both hands. I've always been shaky. I was never.
When you
steady.
Say all, like even when you were 20.
Yeah, even when I was 15, I think.
Oh.
I was never very stable with my fingers.
Okay, you're English.
Yeah.
I can't tell, no, because sometimes if they're Dutch and they speak English, it's yeah.
Don't try
more English
accent. They speak it in a funny way, don't they? They're a bit strange.
Well, they... Very short. <weird. laughs> All right, and anything else, you know, happened to you medically?
No, okay. I've never been in hospital only for this for okay. half a day.
Okay.
Or visiting people.
Yeah.
visiting is
okay. Meniscus, you've got both
knees. Oh, yeah, meniscus.
Both knees.
Yeah.
Both knees.
Was taken out.
Yeah.
But that was outside facility, it doesn't count as hospital.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. Okay. Did you do some sort of weird, interesting sport?
I've always done very heavy work.
Like what?
Making ceilings. And it was all.
Are you making ceilings or painting ceilings?
Making them. Construction work all my life.
Oh, okay.
All sorts of heavy construction work.
Got you.
Very heavy work. I was always doing that.
Okay.
Until 2 years ago.
Anything in your family, his medical history, that you recall?
No, his mother. His mother is. Mentally,
she wasn't stable.
No.
Uh-huh.
The rest of the family
is it either? Okay.
Probably me as well.
All right. Okay. So, the most important thing usually with Parkinson or any neurological disorder is the SCM. And can you see?
Yeah.
His is tight also. I mean, it pops up, literally. It's not just because he's looking to the left, okay? Okay, if you see it's still popping up, and it's still tight, and more on the right than on the left. Okay, now that he's looking straight, do you see how this pops up? This doesn't.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's probably one of
absolutely.
The reasons. The other. Okay. So, and I just because of that, I just want to check quickly. Left side. Oh, yeah. He jumps on the right side.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know about you, a construction worker in the Netherlands or in England?
Both.
Okay. I'm sure in England it's just like in America. In America, construction workers drink lots.
Yeah, I did as well until nine months ago.
Ah.
7th of June last year, I stopped completely. And it was a good idea.
No, I'm... He's like in AA, I am. It's 7th of June, he has a date.
But it's because of an important day for
no,
him.
No, of course. Yeah. No, that's great, that's wonderful.
It was
okay.
A milestone in my life.
You were shaking already at 15?
Not as bad as this.
No, of course. Wait a second.
I didn't dream.
How about eight? That was really my question. Okay.
Oh, a little bit.
A little bit at 15 can be a lot for...
Yeah.
Okay, wait. Age 10, did you have this?
Probably. Because I remember games, but it was 10 or 11 or 12, where you had to keep your hands.
Okay. So there's always been... Okay. Did you know, I know it's your age, people don't always know, there wasn't something, nowadays mothers tell their kids, so somebody 30 or 40 will often know. In your birth, was there something unusual in your birth?
My parents wouldn't have ever talked about it. That was taboo.
Yeah, I understand. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If there was, I don't know.
Yeah, so you don't know. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. Okay. So I'm going to poke abdomen. Right? He has very cold navel. And below as well, but sides are okay. Oh, right side is not. Okay, do you want to come down? This is super. Right? Hand is in the fridge.
Yeah.
This is like, this is the freezer, this is the fridge. And this is, come here. Like almost in the oven.
Yeah.
But the big contrast is this one and this one. So chances are now, and we know he has here. Oh, before you have to, before he jumped, there's something in the liver, clearly. Yeah. Okay, I'm just looking why right side.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And there's something in the liver. Either it's from the liver disturbed circulation to the portal thing to so that. That the chances are high. One, two, yes, something here, right? Three. No?
A little bit.
Number two or number three or both?
Both.
How about this side?
Yeah, that's more.
Okay. That's really. Okay. So. And high blood pressure. Okay. Notice that the left foot rolls out more, which may be why somehow this isn't as tight, that this gets more tight, possibly something to do with the knee or something. By the way, the knees, especially right knee, is very cold, which means that there's stuckness here. What I'm looking at is there's a good chance that there's blockage of circulation from the legs into the abdomen, which is why the navel and the liver are cold. Does that make sense why I'm interested in that? In other words, I need to treat the liver and I need to open this. Now, you can say that this relates to the autonomic nervous system as well. And I need to release the SCM because that's kind of what I need to do. Now, I do not have a story for him. I was trying to make up a story in terms of there's some liver issue, okay, that led to some toxicity, blah, 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 because I'm seeing the liver that therefore creates the Parkinson's. I can't because time-wise it doesn't stand. I can't. Why? Because he's had shaking when he was 10 and he didn't start drinking until later.
Till I was 11.
He started drinking at 11 but had Parkinson's at 10, doesn't work.
Yeah.
That drinking
perhaps
one contributes. No. I believe that the liver thing contributes to the but I cannot say Parkinson's came from a toxicity, that it may still have come from some other toxicity, but not the one I'm thinking of, okay?
Yeah.
So, yes, there's a correlation, and I still want to treat the liver, but there's no definitive. Okay. There is one thing that is definitive, which is his L5. And L5 is relates to parasympathetic feedback to the abdomen. I haven't checked the abdomen, by the way, just to remind you. Okay. Ouch.
Yeah.
Okay. So L5 is still painful. You have a slip disc. How did you fix it?
So you fixed it, and I went to a physiotherapist exercises.
So Sonia still needs to fix a little exercise.
I don't treat him now.
No, it's a joke.
I'm not allowed to treat him.
Ooh, okay. Okay, so some pain here, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm actually in the center. I haven't checked. It'd be easier for me afterwards to check for sure, but I just wanted to see what's going on. Because your sacrum, the sacrum is over a parasympathetic plexus. Okay, something happened at L5, and then this shaking happened more. Plus, he has high blood pressure, which means there is a nervous system component in him.
Yeah.
Now, we know that because he has Parkinson's, but, you know, it's kind of like it's not... In other words, for me, it's not just an L-DOPA. You know, like you can say, okay, there is a neurotransmitter involved. Yes, we know, of course, if he's diagnosed with Parkinson's, it means he has a dopamine issue. Okay, right? They say...
No, they make a DET scan from his brain.
A CAT scan? Uh-huh.
A DET scan. And you can see back here. And if there is a dopamine problem, it's different.
And
but
his is
not hardly.
Okay. And does he take anything?
No, we don't.
Okay. So they're not supplementing any dopamine.
No.
Okay. So they're saying there's slight changes, but not a lot.
No, it's hardly, Avi. You have to look like this and think it might be a little bit smaller, but.
Okay. Let me check abdomen. When I poke here, left side, you just feel my fingers, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. How about here?
Well, that's no problem.
No problem. Here?
No problem.
Okay. Here?
No problem.
Here?
No problem.
Run 9.
Okay.
12.
Okay. Okay.
Wait. Hold on. I don't believe you. Compare this one with this one. That's especially for you. Because I'm feeling something tighter. I want to see if he'll say or not. And if he doesn't, he doesn't. Okay.
Yeah.
But is REN 13 any different than 12?
This 12 is probably a little more pain, but it's such a small amount.
On 12, interesting. Okay. No. Some people, it's not unusual. So, number one, number two. You're saying that number one is more painful.
Okay. But it's not much.
Okay. In my opinion, what he's really saying is, I feel number one, I feel REN 12 more, and he's basically saying that there's some misconnection here. He does, there's a numbness here. Okay, let me compare this one with this one. He said nothing here.
Perfect.
Nothing and nothing? Is there a difference?
That was more... But the difference is so small.
No, I understand. Hold on. You said one and two, that you can feel number one more painful, slightly more painful.
Slightly.
Okay. Now compare number two with number three.
Probably, but it's such small difference.
But tell me what it is.
Yeah.
It's probably I can feel this one more than that one.
Okay, so my theory was wrong. I just wanted a comparison to see, is there numbness here? That was really my point. And there isn't. Because between 12 and 13, 13 feels less. I'm saying maybe 13 is numb, even though it's tighter. So I'm comparing 13 to another point. In other words, I'm always rechecking myself. Okay, how's 15?
Okay.
But something clearly here?
Yeah.
That's the only one that's really clear up to now, right?
Yeah, but it's not so. I've had worse.
I not like you slip disc, but there. With my fingers, you haven't had worse yet.
Okay.
My fingers, this is the worst one. Okay? So here's something.
Yeah.
Compare for me left and right. Because he had L5 maybe to do with the twisting.
Yeah.
But no, he doesn't.
Both of them are about the same.
Okay, that's perfectly fair. And one, two, three. Any discomfort?
No.
Okay. One, two, three.
No.
One, two, three.
No.
One, two,
Well, that's probably more.
Okay, which one?
One, two, and three.
Of one, two, and three. They're all a little bit more.
Three is probably a little less.
A little less. So one and two. Yeah. Scalenes. Oh, sorry?
Scalene?
Yeah. Okay, now. He also has quite tight here. One, two, three, four.
Okay. Three and four, probably.
Three and four.
Yeah.
And how about the... No, let go. Okay. The right side. One, two, three, four.
About the same as the left side.
They both... Okay, so left side you said three and four.
Yeah.
And the right side, one...
Oh, yeah, that's more.
Oi, here.
Yeah.
Okay, so C3. Okay, how about the oxygen? No, okay. You relax, I can get that. One, two, three, four.
Yeah.
Four.
Four.
Okay, close to do 16. And do 16, anything? No. How about one, two, three, four?
Ah, that's okay.
that's okay, okay.
It's so, very difficult.
If you don't worry about it, you just tell me what you feel. You're not responsible for what you're feeling. You're not responsible for telling me what I think.
But I'm responsible to explain it.
No.
It's difficult.
You're responsible, as far as I'm concerned, you're responsible to express when there is something different or discomfortable.
Yeah, okay.
The rest is my responsibility. Okay. So, something clearly here, correct? Something here? No, okay. So something here, and so that's occiput very close to do 16 on the right side, and C3 also on the right side, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, that's obvious, and this one's obvious.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. All right, so, and then he had in the back, this one's obvious, correct? And this one.
Yeah.
Okay.
That one especially.
Oh, this is your especially. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Anything here?
Yeah.
Okay, kidney too. So, see, when it's clear, it's clear. So for you also, when it's clear, it where? Where?
Will.
Yeah. Will.
Okay.
Yeah.
Will or where?
Will.
Will. Okay. Okay. So, like William.
Yes.
Okay. When it's clear, he says, if they don't say... Screw it, you know. It's
can I say screw it if it's not clear?
You can, but it will confuse me. How about here?
Yeah.
Okay. Clearly, kidney to both sides. Okay. So basically, says something to do with adrenals. Okay. Too much desire. You know, burning the burning desires deplete the adrenals is my interpretation. Just because of the point. That's all.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay. Oh, you're not allowed to treat him. But someone who's allowed to treat him.
Everybody.
By the way, this side, okay. Anybody but her. If come touch. What do you think I'm doing? Touch this side. Touch this side. Big difference. This is flaccid. And this, at the end, almost split by kidney 7, there's a little bump, which I'm interested in. You can touch a little. You can go a little bit deeper. Don't push. But you can go a little firmer. You don't have to be that hesitant.
Yeah, that's clear. That's clear, yeah. Don't feel a bump there. Oh, you're there. I thought it was from the
side. Lower, there's lower, there's a bump lower. A little bit more. I think you're about to get there. Yeah, I believe. But I'm not touching right now, so I don't know.
Don't you want to touch, Scott?
Don't you want to touch, Scott? He said, don't you want to touch Scott?
Dear,
dear.
Oh, there. Oh, he's suggesting that now you may touch.
Now I may.
Well, my Melody, I want you to feel like how flaccid this is. The difference between the two sides.
Right,
very clear.
Right.
Forget finding the bump right now. Anyone else wants to feel it? Quickly.
You look like a seed, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is
Okay. So I don't know if really in his case it's desire or heavy work created this, you know, the kidney tube business, but something clearly in his kidney channel gone a little bit wrong. Okay? Then, so my best point for L4, L5 height you have here, correct? Obvious.
Yeah.
Okay.
Spleen 9.
How's now?
Okay.
Better than before?
Yeah.
Lots better than before?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Okay. So I have spleen 9, which is part of high blood pressure anyway, blah, blah, blah. Okay, I'm happy with, I'll do spleen 9. I don't need to prove anything about spleen 9. No big deal. What I want to prove is kidney, you know, I have to do kidney 7, kidney 10. How is this? The back. Forget that.
Back's all right.
The back's all right. Okay. How's the liver?
That's okay.
Do you remember that you had something here?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. And, okay, I'm not pressing on this one. You have something here, right? This is the clearest one you had, right?
Yeah.
Okay. When I press here, forget that point, how's the top of the thigh?
It feels as though you're not pressing hard.
Perfect. How much less am I pressing? If before half. I was pressing half. Okay. So half better. Okay. So it gives me an understanding of what's going on. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, he said. Okay. Let me find them first, and then we'll finish. You have here, and you have here. Correct.
Yeah.
Would you bend this leg for me? Which is a little bit unfair because that changes the growing, so it's a little bit unclear what's going to happen here, but I don't have a choice because I can't reach. How's now?
You mean here?
Yeah. The neck.
That's all right.
That's all right. Okay, so it made a change. Okay, so that's all right means 100%. Don't you think?
Which one are you pressing?
And how is the do 16, this one here in the neck?
Oh, that?
Oh, the do 16's all right.
Do 16's all right, okay. 216 is a piece of all right. I don't think you understand this expression, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. But you do.
Yes.
Yeah.
I do.
Needles. No. Oh, yeah, I do need it. Sorry. Okay. And I still need to do, regardless, I have to do either Sanjo 8 or Sanjo 5, depending on pulse type, because I always, that's my main thing for Parkinson's. By the way, spleen 9, I skipped a step. Besides L4, okay, actually, I'm actually mistaken. Okay. By dogma, his biggest point is spleen 9, and I'm sorry again about the gallbladder 39, they're going to come together. Parkinson's is supposed to have, I don't think he has. I don't recall. I do take them. Actually, he sort of does. Yeah. Do you want? Let me show. Because sometimes they don't show it, but the same. Okay. I suggest if you want to take the pulse, take it on this side. We call wiry pulse. He's not 100% wiry pulse, but it's a strong pulse. You cannot call wiry pulse if it's not strong. Just because wiry is an excess pulse by definition. If you look at the book, wiry is excess pulse. Parkinson's is classical Parkinson's is supposed to have wiry pulse, and the solution is spleen 9, gallbladder 39,
mm-hmm.
then release the SCM. So you see why spleen 9 is an important point for him, because number one, spleen 9 is for L5, which he has. I believe the tremors got worse when the nervous system got shocked with the L5, okay? So
yeah.
Spleen 9 is an important point because of the back, because of the high blood pressure, and because of the Parkinson's.
Mm-hmm.
Three things you have that give you spleen 9.
The shaking always is worse when with emotions.
With emotion.
Absolutely emotions.
Me, what, any kind of emotion?
Any kind.
Okay, whether happy or unhappy?
Not with happy, but with
worry. Worry and
is worry a big thing for you? You tend to worry a lot?
Yeah.
Okay, he's a worry type. Okay. But nothing.
And
here.
Fear.
No.
And fear.
Yeah.
Okay. The fear can be, this is uncomfortable. Okay.
Yeah.
Can you, if you don't mind, just remember right side, what it feels like, because I'll ask you in a minute if it's better, and left side.
Okay? Yeah, they're about the same.
Yeah, yeah, but, so, okay, so you just have to remember one.
I won't
forget that. Okay. Okay, so kidney 7. Because if he has that, that's kind of prime. Kidney channel, you want to start treating kidney channel first. And 10. And this one's the 7, rather than take official 7, I'll take, because there's a very tiny bump here. Because remember, she says the changes in his brain are not that great. Okay, mm-hmm. not as big. So the bump is not as obvious, and it's not as close to kidney 3 as it often would be. But you can see that this side, kidney 7, is, it's not, I would have taken it, you see that there's a difference in height. Okay. And 10. And, hi, how's now compared to before?
Somewhat better.
Okay, can you give me a percentage? It also takes 50% time.
50% better.
Okay, that's fair. That's fine. Okay, next. Okay. How's this guy?
That guy's all right.
That guy's all right. All right. How about this guy?
That guy's all right.
Okay, so what this tells us, now, of course, kidney 7 is also part of liver excess treatment, unfortunately. By the way, it's not just that kidney 7 is part of liver treatment. Any kidney point is part of liver treatment. Liver, if you clean the kidneys, you're cleaning the liver, and sort of the other way around. They are highly correlated. Mm-hmm. The liver detoxifies, and the kidney detoxifies too. They're both, most people who are on dialysis or anything with actual physical, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. You kind of looked a little glazed.
Yeah, I was.
Well, I kept pushing him for answers, so he's tired. Most people, when you start asking people who have kidney problems, physical kidney problems, dialysis, stuff like that, you will find a liver underlying issue for them. So they're correlated. Okay, so, and how is DU16?
DU16's okay.
Okay. And C3.
C3's okay.
Shit. Okay, because I don't have enough to test with. That's a problem. That's why I don't like needling up front. But I've tested enough up to now. So I just want to see if there's anything else.
Kidney 2 is still painful.
Yeah, but that could be just time. Hold on. That's why I don't want to. Okay. He's okay.
Yeah.
Totally. No problem.
Yeah.
And... I don't think I'm on this mic.
That's okay. I can feel it a bit.
A bit.
But the differences are so small. Okay. Sometimes I'm not sure if I'm lying or not.
Don't worry about it. Mm-hmm. It's not you. It's not. Oh, you. I told you, your issue is to express what you're feeling. You don't have to evaluate what you're feeling. Just tell me what you feel, okay? So, a little bit here.
A little bit.
How's now? In the back.
Probably a bit less. But it's so small, the differences are so small.
Okay. No. Okay. But before you had a lot here.
Yeah.
It was obvious.
Yeah.
And now it's gone, is what you're saying. Yeah. But I tested spleen 9 before. What I didn't test is Gallbladder 39, what I didn't test is Sanjiao 8. So I'm screwed and I'm just going to have to do that. So that's the answer for I made a mistake in, not testing some points that I knew I was going to use or I wanted to use. My mistake, fine, no problem. Yeah. I heard a sort of a question coming.
Yeah, actually. would you consider kidney 27 as well?
I could. Yeah, I would. I am of the school, in terms of kidney 27, I'm of the school that kidney 27 is is, you know, when I have kidney below kidney 16, I will add. In other words, I'm consider this as sort of adrenal, sort of not.
Yeah.
And it's not a, you know, and I'm also of the school that I don't do adrenal one side. It is impossible, in my opinion, okay, to have only one adrenal depleted and not the other. Oh, I was working so hard, and my right kidney, my right adrenal is depleted, but my left is fabulous. So they work together. If one, now, it's possible that one side shows and the other side doesn't, so you do the other side as prevention.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, is it possible to do kidney 7 and 10 one side and kidney 9 the other? Yes, that is absolutely.
Okay.
That I'm happy to do.
Okay.
But to do adrenal just one side, I know Kiiko does that a lot nowadays, in the old days, and David is the one who started it. And I once asked Kiiko, you know, do you do that, the one side? And she said, no, I don't do that. I don't do one side, but she does now. Okay, I still, like, if there is adrenal, I believe the other side needs to be addressed also.
Yeah.
You know, that's because it's systemic. Okay.
Afi.
Yeah.
You said you were fucked up with the Sanja 8 and Gobler 39 because you can't check.
I haven't checked.
But can't you check it on the kidney 2 area?
Yes, I can. I can. No. And okay, since everyone... Gobler 39 is unfair. I'll tell you right off. So first of all, let's check what's left. Okay.
Yeah.
Gobler 39 and kidney channel are highly correlated.
Yeah.
So unfair to check Gobler 39 against kidney 2 because I'll probably get some what I want. But... Sanjo 8 is not related, so that I can't check. Okay, how much is left here?
Yeah, there's some bits left. You mean, can I feel it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
More than just more than just my finger.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so something left. I know it's difficult to say, but how much is left percentage-wise? If there was 100% before, it was ouch before, and this was less ouch, I know. How much is left on the ouch?
At least half of it.
Okay. Because I thought with time it might, but it hasn't done it, so now I can test things against it. Now I have more confidence in it. How is now? The bottom.
Left. It less, I mean.
Yeah, how much?
That side's less, yes,
yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, this guy here that I'm rubbing, How much is left here? It was 100% before, then we were at 50. How much are we at now?
30,
okay.
You've got to understand, I found it very difficult
yeah.
to give it as...
You just make up a number. I'm okay.
A number.
Don't worry, you make one up.
Okay.
If it's not, no one can... It's not as if I can check and say, no, he really means 27. Nobody knows exactly what the number is.
Always up, huh?
Always up, Gobler 39. Gobler 39 and UB60 are the 2 points that we do against the channel.
You got a thicker needle now?
I didn't, because I don't do thicker needles.
Okay.
But yeah, officially you should do a thicker needle, yes. Very good.
Do you feel where the bump is?
Yeah, well, it's hard from this position. I will probably do Gobler 39 again on the other side. I'm just starting to, How are we doing here?
If it was 30, it's 25.
Okay. And how about the left side?
20.
Okay. Shoulders tight. It's hard for me to get the okay.
Yeah, yeah.
His pulse tends more towards slow, in my opinion. Okay.
I do have blood pressure pills.
Yeah.
Beta blockers.
Ah. Okay. Anything left here?
Not much, no.
Okay, not much. Tell me if there's any change. You can say no, you can say yes, you can say whatever you feel.
Yes, a little bit of change, but...
Mm.
can you let go of the arm? So he holds very tightly.
I don't mean to.
I know. I should have said the arm is held very tightly.
Yeah, that I can feel that.
Okay. And that actually seems to produce more. Okay. That produces more.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
Mm-hmm.
Ow.
Sorry.
You don't have to say sorry, just don't do it.
But I have to do it, so I have to say sorry.
Okay.
This is aggravating also, I think. It's okay.
Kidney one? What about kidney one?
Why?
Because
it's not in my style, that's one. Oh, yeah, I understand what you're thinking. You know, yeah, I it's not quite my... I'm happy to try, though. I'm always...
Was the scalenus still tight?
He's going to have very hard time to say. But plus, the scalenus was on this side.
That's the problem.
Shaking. If I'm looking at something that will affect. Okay. Anything here?
Yeah.
Okay. Forget spleen 3 for a second.
What did you say?
No. Unfortunately, I'm talking to two people at the same time. I'm talking to you and I'm talking to them too.
Jue
of Taiyin. How is the neck?
Better.
By how much?
50%.
50, okay. Hold on. Versus now?
40%.
Okay, so in other words, now you understand why I want the percentages. This one does a better job for the neck, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, because 50 is better than 40. So that's why I'm asking for the percentages, not because they need to be exact.
No, it doesn't matter.
The reason why I'm looking for Jue of Taiyin more than spleen 3.
Mm-hmm.
Spleen 3 is supposed to release the scalenes, but actually I'm more interested because of the muscular, because this kind of tightness,
yeah.
I'm trying to release that more than anything else.
Because it's on the long channel as well, long and spleen.
No. Because Jue, because he has a symptom, the symptom is in the brain, meaning Jue points work good for things in either in the chest or in the head. Okay, so that's why I'm looking. I would rather do, you know, if I could, if it's going to help. Symptoms in the chest or the head. That's the definition of Jue. Something in the foot went up to the disturbing the chest or the head. I think that makes him shake more.
No.
Only the thumb.
I don't think so.
It's only the thumb.
So that means we need itchy points. All right. How's now?
That's all right.
Okay. How is kidney 2?
Is that kidney 2?
That is kidney 2. If I'm touching it, I'm saying, I'm naming it for them, but I'm touching for you.
A little bit. It hurts a little bit.
Okay.
Or it doesn't even hurt. It's a little uncomfortable.
Okay. And this side?
Less uncomfortable than that side.
Yeah, it always was. Yeah. Okay. All right, and L5 is okay. He does, even though the MRI, the CAT scan doesn't show changes here. But if you touch DU16,
that you can. There's. It's thicker on him.
Just the blood pressure.
That. Well, not in the blood pressure doesn't show in the center in my experience. Blood pressure shows more under the occiput on the sides, but the center itself not so much. No discomfort here, right?
No.
Maybe okay. in working his atlas is out. The atlas.
Atlas. You cannot feel the atlas in the center. It's between bones.
Yeah.
So the atlas you'll feel at the top of the SCM under the mastoid.
Good.
You won't feel. Yeah.
Okay.
Hold on. No discomfort, right?
No.
I don't have body, I don't have anything by pressure pain to check. Okay, in my opinion, this is a very hard one to evaluate. The hand is still. This is, because he was shaking here also.
Mm-hmm.
And the leg, I'm not seeing. Can someone put your hand on the right leg to see if you feel? There is a shaking?
There's some shaking.
Okay, hold on, keep your hand there.
We can see.
Okay, because I can't see from this distance, unfortunately. Okay. I know when you touch it, you can feel it. Okay,
yeah,
now
I can
I'm seeing
see
it. Now I, okay, but I let go of 224. Okay.
Yeah.
I know. John, would you mind touching? No, because I know that it looks, but I'm wondering how it feels. Same. Okay. So do 24 didn't do it. Okay, next. Wait, no. Nothing left here?
Yes, some pain.
Okay, some pain, okay. How is now?
Not much difference.
Okay, fine. And now?
Not much difference.
Okay. Okay. But totally different abdomen.
Yeah.
And we're not finished, but this is still colder, but
this is better.
And this is not quite as frigid.
No.
Okay, hold on.
Yeah, that's painful. Yeah, that's painful.
That's pain. Okay, great. I'm looking for painfuls. I need to find it. Painful. Okay. And now?
Less.
By how much?
Half.
Would you press on
the
third
toe? Well, do
you have
a gallbladder point?
Hold on, I'll tell you a second.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second.
Ow, the toes.
Okay, I'm sorry about the toes. How is the groin?
That's, okay, but I can feel it.
Okay, can you guesstimate how much?
A little bit less than a minute ago.
Just a little bit less.
Yeah.
Okay, let go. So this is one option. And go ahead. And this is the second option. Which one do you like better?
They're both about the same.
Okay, so since I'm really doing, okay. So, this gallbladder 15, 17, the blah, 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 I consider this to be marrow points.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, also related to gallbladder 39. Okay. So, and it does affect it. So, we will see how much we can extract from this. Can I have some more of these?
I can help you. Don't worry.
You gotta do them all.
I don't do them all. I do whatever bumps I find.
Yeah, you found them.
Not that.
16.
Okay. So, this is 50% better. Do you see?
Definitely.
Okay, that's his first definite, by the way.
No, I did.
How's now?
Good.
Okay. So I'm adding a lot more. Now, because number one, he is not a pain issue, and number two, he has a liver sign. I can't just do the left side. Kiiko says, yeah, oh, you know, for pain, you know, the research shows that the left side is the one that controls. But if you're talking about a neurological condition, it may not be just left side, but more importantly, remember he has a liver sign. Okay, so
She will say if it's more depression type, she will do the right side.
Because it's blood.
Because Japanese scientists tell us this.
Oh, okay. I believe. Okay. I can talk to the Japanese science, but the scientists. Okay, so this is okay now?
Yeah.
Okay. Is there anything left here?
Hardly.
Hardly. Okay, fine. So we would love to... No.
Just
I'm not pressing yet. Hold on. Okay, now you can check.
I'm not sure any difference.
Okay. Hold on. Oh, all the others. Oh. Try now.
I don't feel the difference.
Okay. Has anybody noticed when when the thumb stopped and the index finger started? Because it was reversed before. There was some involvement in the index finger before. One of the problems with Parkinson's is that if they know what you're doing, because attention and Parkinson's are highly correlated. Some people when they focus, they no longer shake. So it's an unfair, thing to do. Okay, so will that, again, you know, sometimes you can't get definitive responses. You work with dogma. You just do what you can. What you can do is this. I know by dogma that Sanjiao 8 will do a good job, but look what happens. Well, actually, it doesn't happen anymore. No, it's increasing. So I know I have to stay away from it. Sanjiao 8 is not a point that I would risk right now.
For a moment, it was less.
For a moment, who wants a treatment that for a moment is less than the Mixbook word?
No.
it's just not...
And how about another point on the meridian?
I don't. It doesn't work quite like that always. Sometimes you can say that if I'm using that meridian, that's the meridian I'm interested in. But often, you can, but... would you try Joy of Thurto? Just once already. So, yeah, take under Thurto and go to the Joy line, basically. Because under Thurto didn't do it, but... Okay. So, if you... Well, just going to wait a second. No. They're related because it increases, actually, but I'm still not... As a first-time patient, I'm not comfortable doing something that's increasing. And another time, I might say. Now, the thing about substituting points on a channel, sometimes yes and sometimes no, and it's I don't have a good answer for why yes and why no. But basically, each point, you can substitute a point for another point in the area, something that's called, in other words, spleen 9 can be here, it can be here, you know. But to say, instead of spleen 9, I'm going to use spleen 7, it depends on why you chose spleen 9. If you chose it because it's...
Lionel.
Now my arm's hurting, just from shaking.
Yeah, his arms, it hurts.
My arm's always hurting, either here or here, for shaking. I'm not cold.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's all the time.
Wait, and it's because you showed here, but he's showing here.
Yeah, this whole arm.
It's here, sometimes it's here. It's nearly always here.
Run it up and put it.
He said he's not. Oh no!
I'm not cold at all.
Support under the elbow.
Okay. Oh, it's all right. I'm used to it. I don't think it'll help.
It sounds like
Don't worry, I'm used to my sciatica. Don't bother
don't
treating
worry,
it.
Don't worry, they'll sew it back on again.
Okay. Is that more comfortable? Does that make it more comfortable?
Yeah, for a while, but I'll have to move.
Yeah, I understand. Okay. So, but for a while it's more comfortable, so why not?
Thank you.
Okay. Is there any pain left?
Not really at the moment, no.
Oh, okay, so I can't test it. Okay, I'll let go.
Now there's pain.
Now there's pain, okay. Sorry, how's the pain?
Oh, that's a little bit less.
UB 42, how much less?
Yeah, but look at it shaking now.
I know. Well, we changed position. We kind of...
Yeah.
We're talking about the pain now.
It's probably even less than anybody's moving. It's so fucking complicated, isn't it?
It's okay. It's okay. Yes, it is. All right, we'll let you rest for a little bit, okay? Enough is enough, right? All right, any questions?
I know prognosis is difficult about your blood, but realistically, what are your experiences and what results?
With Parkinson's?
With Parkinson's? Or?
I've had some decent success and some total not. I never give prognosis to people until the second or third treatment. First treatment is an experiment, you know, for me. So to then talk about, you know, prognosis you can only give after you've seen what the treatment actually did. Otherwise, it's totally, it's too theoretical.
I know, but they are basically in a situation where usually they're looking for options and they want to have some feeling that they can expect something realistically.
So they're going to have to wait one more week.
No. Yeah, but what is your...
I mean, it's not like I'm saying I have no... You know. But so if on the second treatment they say, you know, I can see results, I can say, okay, then I believe that there is a possibility of a decent prognosis. But if they say nothing, I say, well, let's try one more to see if there... And then I can say, okay, I can tell you that you have a great prognosis, that I can do it for sure because I didn't prove that I can. So now it's totally up to you. If you think it's worth trying, I'm happy to, you know. Now, I'm not saying, because for example, second treatment, I may decide, you know, screw it, I'm doing under third toe, and let's see what it does. So it's a continuous experiment. Certain things on the first treatment are probably not a good idea. Something aggravates a condition on the first treatment, I wouldn't do it. So that requires that the patient comes back in order for you to really experiment. Unless you're saying, well, screw it, I'll do it anyway.
No.
That's not what I'm not willing.
One patient I had who had Parkinson's, I treated, I don't know, not so many times, 3-4 times.
Mm-hmm.
And I explained more or less the similar thing. And after second treatment, she said, well, I feel more, she had more the claw version. Mm-hmm. So more relaxed, and try to feel more relaxed, and yeah, I can move more easily. So her question really was like, okay, is there any chance that this
will get to, I will be normal?
No, not even normal. But like, is it like a really temporary thing? You know, you have to come the rest of your life for every week, or is it like there's some chance that we will reach, you know, like.
Something that's better.
Yeah.
I think that the answer, there's no answer to that.
Okay.
In my opinion, because I don't know. No one knows. Now, I think that to say, you know, are you going to come for the rest of your life once a week? No, but you're going to come the rest of your life once every month or once every 3 months. Once a week, no, but because if that's the case, you basically didn't do it. But it's always up to the patient as to how much they're willing, you know, what they want.
Well, it is quite common, I believe, here, I don't know, in the United States, for physiotherapists or psychologists, when they
say 10 treatments and blah,
oh no,
blah, blah,
they say chronic condition, you know.
Of
like
course.
10 years or
yes,
you know.
Of course.
And I don't think
but the advantage is, well, it's not very nice, but the advantage for them is, you know, that I assume that they get paid in a slightly different way.
They do.
So it's a bit, you know, we usually don't want to say that just because it's kind of like, well, you lost the patient up front if you
yeah.
say that. But that is the reality sometimes. You know, some diseases are,
yeah, yeah,
they ain't going
away. There's some middle ground between, you know, the rest of your life. 3 times a week
yeah, well, 3 times a week, yeah. Rest of your eye 3 times a week is really, you know, listen, if it helps the person and that's the only option they have, then you do. But certainly wouldn't be my favorite, plus I don't see anybody 3 times a week, so
no.
It's like, it's not an option for me. You know, it's be an option for someone else. All right.
Avi,
yeah.
The kidney-liver correlation,
yeah.
Are there special points you can address in the kidney
to
do the liver more, like kidney 9?
Yeah, kidney 9 is, but, okay, yeah, so supposedly kidney 9 is a point that's good for liver, but look at it another way, is that kidney 9 is your best point for actual physical kidney issue. The 2 points that we generally use for liver, which is kidney 7 and or kidney 9, okay, both are actually points that actually deal with the kidney. A lot of kidney symptoms are actually, you know, are things that you will associate with toxicity, like skin problems or things like that. So a lot of the kidney and the liver are just the Western ones are highly correlated. So I can't say kidney 4 is a good point for liver. See, that's why, who was it that asked about substituting a point?
Kidney 4.
Yeah, but, you know, not just because not all points in the meridians are good substitutes for another point in the meridian. So, for example, if Sanjiao 8, because it started with Sanjiao 8 was painful, or, you know, is there another Sanjiao point I could use? Not really, because in this case, it's not all Sanjiao points release the neck. I'm looking at releasing the neck. Okay, so that's why, you know, so it's the same thing. Kidney 4 will not be something that would automatically come up with liver. But if either kidney 7 or kidney 9 will come up for liver.
Yeah.
So.
But should a kidney 9 relieve the tension in the arm, do you think?
Could kidney 9? Well, at this point I can't do it, but I'm happy to try. Doesn't look like it.
Yeah.
And the thing is, I'm relatively committed to 7 and 10. By the way, how is this guy here?
I can still feel it.
Okay, compared to the very beginning.
There's something less, but I can still feel it.
Okay. Would you mind 25% less, 50% less, 75% less? Just a quarter, half, you know, just to give me a rough idea of how much better. Only 40, okay.
How about Roto Dumo 2?
Sorry?
Roto Dumo 4.
But I can't right now.
If
it will do anything?
It's already 20 minutes that the needles have been in, isn't it?
Yeah. No. I understand. No, so kidney 7-10 is not enough of a solution. But, okay, I can try do 4, but actually I have a better... If I'm going to do that, I'd rather do UB52, but here's do 4. How's the foot?
The same as just.
Okay, so now let me try UB. Now.
Same. Probably worse.
Okay. Yeah, no, it happens like that. Some people, you know, basically everything here points to autonomic nervous system imbalance. Okay. So next time I may do Sanjiao 8, I may go for under third toe. He does have high blood pressure after all, etc. So I'm just choosing to be more concerned the first time, because the thing is, if you get no change, it's one thing. They may not come back. But if you make it worse, they for sure don't come back. Okay, so it's a big deal to, you know, for in the first treatment, not, you know, even though you want to do things, to let go of that. And even, oh, by the way, this one, yeah, 11 has still a teeny bit there. He didn't feel it to begin with, so that's why I'm not asking him to, you know. But that's an area that's very important for neurological problems also. I cannot needle it on him, okay, because he has high blood pressure. I don't like needling, you know, REN 12 area for high blood pressure. When they have high blood pressure. Okay. We're going to turn you over. So you, gallbladder 39, yeah. Sorry.
If you're turning me over, I'll take my glasses off.
Yes, please. But before you do that, if you don't mind sit, walking, stand up and walk and tell us how
we're feeling. Are all the needles out?
We don't know, but we'll find out. I believe they are.
Yeah. Oh, no, that's all right. Oh, no.
What do you want me to do? A pirouette?
Hmm?
Did you want a pirouette or something?
Do I want what? Do you want a pirouette? Yeah, well, yeah, if you want to do a pirouette, you can do a pirouette.
Just for a walk?
Yeah. I'm just wondering how things feel. Oh, by the way, there was the knee. Shit, I forgot about that. Okay. How are you feeling?
All right. Just this. I'm always crazy about this.
Yeah.
It
can drive you crazy.
You get crazy about it.
Yeah. All right, let's put you face down. Do we... Is that okay? All right. Lift your legs up for a second. Good. Okay, that's good. All right. Any discomfort anywhere?
Some in the back, some there. Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. A little bit.
A little bit?
Yeah, there.
Okay, here and here.
Yes.
Okay. How about L5?
Some discomfort.
Some discomfort. Sorry. When I press on L5, how is this one and how is this one?
Less.
By how much?
Difficult to say. 40%.
Okay, you know, just teeny, a little bit. Half better or lots better is fair, is good.
Yeah, that's, yeah, okay.
Okay, so would you say one and two?
Half.
Number one, half. Okay, half. Okay, next. How is number one and how is number two?
Oh, that's all right. A lot better.
A lot better. Okay. Besides, I use lots for anything autonomic nervous system, plus... You know, don't they say due to is for epilepsy, different, granted, because that now we call, you know, we say epilepsy, not Parkinson's, but still shaking.
Yeah.
Right? So, all you know, it's not like I invented due to is good for autonomic nervous system or Kiiko invented due to is good for autonomic nervous system. It's by function, you know, just by, it's the virtue of being in the tailbone, okay? Because when you stick your tailbone out... And when you tuck your tailbone under, it affects your nervous system. Okay, the tailbone, you know, how the and the whole sacrum relates to the autonomic, you know, it relates to parasympathetic nervous system. There's a parasympathetic plexus here. Are they okay now?
Yeah.
Okay. Any pain left here?
There,
yeah, okay, hold on. Now, He had liver on the front. One, two, three. Anything?
No.
How about here?
No.
But you had here before, right? Because I was pressing you before, yes. You two before, because of, to see if the pain in the arm would get better. Anything?
No.
So that's what patients do. They don't show. They refuse to show. Fine, no problem. So I believe there's still liver issue. So I pretend there's something here, which I can't check. So I do left UB35. And I didn't have anything to check it against. Too bad. It's okay. Anything left here?
Yes.
Okay. He said he does the construction work and lots of heavy labor. Okay, how's now?
Are you asking me?
I'm asking you. Yes. If I'm asking how something is, it must be you.
Yeah.
No, I know you don't.
Okay.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. UB36 is called support.
Yes.
Cheng Fu.
Sorry?
Cheng Fu. Cheng is to receive.
Support?
Fu, to support.
Okay.
Okay? You have a number of supports in the bladder channel, because it supports your posture. But this one has double support. Usually I use it for more for musculoskeletal stuff. It's different. When you talk and he knows you're talking about it, it will change regardless. But it got slower.
Yeah.
No, it's the nature. It's the nature of Parkinson's. There's nothing. It's the way.
No, I understand you. I can.
Also, autonomic nervous system. I do small intestine 9-10.
Yeah.
And nothing here, right?
No.
Checking T5.
I don't even know if the needles in. Have you put needles in?
Yes, I have. I think he's suggesting to you that you need thinner needles.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very subtle way of saying it, isn't it? If I use UB36, another point that is not the same, somewhat same connotation is DU12, pillar of the body. I mean, it's not gone, but if it gets... No, if the frequency is a teeny bit less, then I'm assuming that it affects it.
Yeah.
You know, so you suddenly have to work with guessing. There's no... Not every patient's going to be obvious and clear for you. Maybe they'll be obvious and clear to some other practitioner, but not to you. You just have to accept that it's the nature of it.
And what about... doing some more on gallbladder 39.
To redo 39, yes.
I would consider doing moxibustion just to give it, to stimulate it more intensely.
I don't do mox on gallbladder 39. Has just never been a mox point for me. I know TCM people do that,
okay.
But I've never it's never resonated for, so I can't say.
Okay.
Yeah. I think so. Yeah. So UB36, I often use more than one because it's the hallway that the hamstring is attached. Even, you know, this area is very important. By the way, most people... Most people, if you look at them, because it's hard to evaluate, but most people sit like this. They're not sitting on their thigh, they're sitting on their buttocks. Okay? So that's why, you know, that's partially, I mean, it's obvious why this area is so important. It supports the whole body. Okay? But, so sometimes I'll do two or three, you know, three or four even.
Oh, yeah.
In here. But it has nothing to do with Parkinson's, obviously, you know, just in general for people. But I'm trying to... Okay, this is gone. I think. Teeny bit.
It's gone.
This one's... Yeah, something's changing.
Intradermal needles.
Forever. You are cruel. Every time they sit down, they go.
At least they don't have
if it works.
Intradermal, different from
perhaps,
right?
Can you really use...
It's a
hip,
though. You never
stimulate
the needles.
Didn't you just...
Yeah.
I'm going to play Kiiko. Didn't you just see I do this?
No. I mean,
I did. I honestly...
Every 5 minutes, you have to... Whatever.
Well, anybody can say anything they want. The truth
it's
is...
It's
who,
just a question if you...
Kiiko, who sees three people an hour... does not have time to stimulate every 5 minutes. I can guarantee you that much. I think I can guarantee you that. You know, if you want to, you can. That's very nice. All these rules, most of us put the needles in, stimulate teeny bit. Some are, actually,
yeah,
best if you don't have to stimulate. If you have to stimulate, but you don't have to come back 30 times to do it.
Oh, yeah, I lost it.
Yeah, I probably did.
How do you feel with the arm right now?
No, okay, I can still feel.
I know, but is it better or not, in your opinion?
What do you mean, better, less pain, or less
shaking? Less shaking, because it's shaking that bothers you most,
no,
right?
Yeah, it seems to be less shaky, but it could be because I'm resting. It's
I understand that.
Because it...
Yeah, I totally understand.
Could be because it's not straight out.
Okay, here's what I want you to do. I want you to get up, but hold on, before you do that, do not roll over.
No, I understand that.
In other words, take your legs over to this side and push with your arms to get up. Yes, no, that's okay, he's okay. Is anything uncomfortable? Okay, no, then don't.
Seems to be a little less shaky.
Yeah.
I still couldn't be an acupuncturista with it. I'd kill somebody.
I'll tell you a secret, I've killed about 30.
30?
without now.
Shaking.
All right, let's put you back up. And left you rest for a few more minutes, and then we'll take them out. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
So we said, okay, we start doing not moxa, but we'll just redo gallbladder 39 because it is a better position to find gallbladder 39. That's for sure. Oh, that I didn't notice before.
What?
It's very
dry.
Mushy and soft. Well, forget the dry, but very mushy and soft. Very unusual.
Oh,
yeah.
Most people are tight around Gobbler 39.
Yeah.
This type, maybe I will. This one I'm happy to mock some.
Because
of that, yeah. Well, it's just like there's no holding there at all. And I've never seen someone with Gobbler 39 that's like that. Oh, hello. Give us 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Sit here?
Yes, yes. I'm sorry. Any questions?
No.
Okay, no. Okay, clear as mud. Okay, good. You had questions, right?
So
do you have any questions? Yes.
Oh.
You said you had lots of questions.
All about Parkinson's. No.
About anything else?
Yeah. About rheumatic scleroderma.
Okay, so she asked. You know, she asked originally. She said she has a patient with rheumatic scleroderma and also
it's called
Raynaud's.
Yeah, it's a combination of that.
Okay, so that both. Raynaud's does not always have to be, autoimmune disorder, but it could be. But for sure, scleroderma is an autoimmune disorder. So autoimmune, I always do, like I was trying on him, has to be kidney and lung, okay, because it's systemic fire. Your main point is REN4 unless it's slow pulse. So you use kidney point and lung point because it's like metal water, systemic metal water, okay? Which kidney points? Depends. Whichever ones do the best job for abdomen or neck. Which lung points? Same thing. Now, again, it's not which one does the best job for a particular point in the abdomen, which one does the best job for all of your findings. Okay? And REN4 if the pulse is not slow. And on the back I do UB27 or UB26 if you want. They're both equivalents of REN4. Okay? UB27 is the small intestine shoe. So small intestine mu and shu. UV26 is called Guan Yuan shu. REN4 is called Guan Yuan. So they're, yeah. But the point is, one of the things, that if there are two findings that you may find in autoimmune type patients, okay? One is puffiness in the sacroiliac ligaments, like you'll find like little ping pong balls. And the other one is you'll find puffiness under the mastoid. It's not a must. It's not like for sure they have it, but it's quite typical. Okay, so those two, there are no actual, you know, like some things we say, you know, diabetes has, puffy around T11, T12. Adrenals should show officially under kidney 16. You know, we don't have any dogma for what's supposed to show with autoimmune. But I'm telling you that lots of autoimmune patients will have the ping pong feeling in the sacroiliac, and puffiness under the mastoid, okay? So you can test against that if you want, but also especially the sacroiliac ligaments are actually a treatment point, okay? So on the back I do UB26 or 27, I do the sacroiliac. Then for the kidney, I either do UB23 or 52. For the lungs, I do UB13 or UB42. UB42, I needle out towards the scapula. UB52, I needle in towards the spine. Okay? And if it's bladder 13 or bladder 23, just with the flow of the channel. Okay? So that's like the dogma for autoimmune disorders. Okay? So, and you can always, somebody has slow pulse, you cannot do REN4, but you're still doing front treatment, so you're still doing kidney plus lung. But you can do REN4. That's also true, by the way, someone who has Crohn's. I don't want to do REN4 because the small intestine inflamed. I don't want to needle into close to the small intestine. You can substitute with Mushu. Okay? So those are, you know. So anybody who comes with autoimmune disorder, that's where I start. You know. Then you can add. Other diseases that are of that nature, somebody comes and has diabetes or has lots of family diabetes, it starts to put weight. Oh,
father's side and mother's side both contribute to you possibly one day having diabetes. I start. Spleen 3 is my main point, but also, oh, I should have checked OD point on him. Yeah. Not because of diabetes, but because of the spasms. Somebody who has diabetes from both sides of the family, I start looking diabetes treatment. Spleen 3 plus adrenal treatment, meaning kidney below the knee plus 27, plus immune, plus OD, which is navel to the ribs, 45 degrees halfway. And on the back, it's T11, T12. Doesn't matter what the person came for. You know, if they're especially if they're diabetic, for sure, I start with that. But diabetes in the family, at least check that to see what it does. Then I'll add more things for whatever they came for as well. But diabetes is a primary diagnosis, meaning you cannot ignore. You can't just say, I'll treat something else and hope the diabetes gets better. Because diabetes, autoimmune, thyroid, by the way, is also, you've got to treat thyroid as a primary, and autonomic nervous system. These are things that you've got to treat because they affect the metabolism of every cell in the body. Okay, you can say, okay, Walter, you have a cough, but I don't have to treat that as primary. I can treat something. It may not affect everything in his body. But if he says, I have a thyroid issue, I can't say I won't treat your thyroid. I have to start treating the thyroid. It doesn't mean it's the only thing I treat. It doesn't mean I have to treat the thyroid until he has a blood test. That's fine. It means I'm treating the thyroid. 2 seconds later, I can treat more. Okay, but I have to address diabetes, autoimmune, thyroid, autonomic nervous, blood pressure, especially disorders. Because if they have especially if they have low blood pressure, you're putting needles in the low blood pressure, nothing's happening. Then you do under the third toe, and everything starts to move. Yeah. Okay, it's quite typical. Okay, or sometimes you put Sanjiao 8, you release the SCM, and suddenly everything starts moving better. So these are primary. They're not more primary than adrenal in a sense of importance. Diagnostically, notice that most of them contain adrenal in them. It's kind of an interesting phenomenon. But they're primary in terms of they affect every cell in the body. Therefore, they need to be addressed. Okay? Anything else? Now you're sorry you didn't take lunch. Do you want to come in for a moment? Yeah. Before your patient.
Yeah.
Before her. Do you want to come? I was going to invite you to put Prestax on if you know, but you don't have to. No. I'm just kidding. You do want to put Prestax on? Okay.
What do you want to do?
He's your guinea pig. You liked the Prestax on UB36, didn't you? Who was it that liked Prestax on UB36?
No, you saw Yarnus.
Nick? No, she. I thought that was you. It was Sunny. Oh, I got you. I'm sorry.
Joking.
I got confused.
That's what Intradermals, you said.
He's 36?
This was a joke.
Oh, okay. But it was you.
It was me.
Okay.
Yeah. See, it was a joke.
Everybody got
it. Sorry. But I want to.
No, then if it was a joke, you don't have it. I was just joking also. Come do them. All right, let's have you stand up. How does it feel?
What?
How does it feel?
Yeah, but what is it?
How do you feel? It, she, or you, whatever.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
I know it's still there. I can see.
Yeah. I don't... Yeah. Okay.
All right, fair enough.
Right.
We didn't expect that it was gone.
I'm not expecting gone. I'd like gone.
It's this. It's just this. It's still there. It's always there. That's the worst thing. For me, that's the worst thing.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
You as well.
Thank you.
Oh,
all right.